Hello, dear EDIUS community. Here is Michael Lehmann-Horn from EDIUS.NET, and I'm in Kobe, Japan at Grass Valley, where the magic happens, where EDIUS is developed. With me today is Nobumasa Tamaoki, and he is the boss of the engineers of the software development of EDIUS. Tamaoki-san, in EDIUS 11, the new version 11.10, there were some news with a GPU. Can you explain a little bit what happened in that version?
Yeah, so in the latest version of EDIUS 11, that we enabled a GPU rendering pipeline, especially for the importer part of the acceleration. So we already provided the QuickSync capability in the past versions, but this version also enabled to use the decoder in the Nvidia GPU. So
right. So in the past, people who had a like Intel-based system, in these CPUs, there is often Intel QuickSync already included because they have an internal GPU. But for those customers, for example, who used a AMD Ryzen or Intel Xeon or another Intel CPU without QuickSync technology, without this internal GPU, there's now also acceleration.
Yes, correct.
The acceleration is for the decoding. So what files are typically decoded with a higher performance?
Yeah, so the most most important use case is the action cam or the drone recorded by the drone. Yeah, like 4K or over the more resolution MP4, yeah. The AVC format, and also not only AVC format, but also the HEVC format. Yeah.
So based on H.264 and H.265. And you mentioned the drones. We have seen that customers get problems with some special like DJI footage because the encoding of this footage is very complex, is a one slice. So the whole picture is compressed in one process. It's very hard for the software codecs, for the software decoder to make this fast because it's just one core which can work on it.
Okay. Yeah. So usually the how to say, like XD, XAVC or those kind of the broadcast format are encoded in the multi-slice format. Mm-hmm. So the multi-core CPU can decode those kind of format faster. Yeah. But for the drone or the action cam, that they are using the hardware codec with the one slice, yeah. And the CPU cannot decode the efficiently. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so using the GPU decoder, we can provide more better performance to decode the single slice format.
Yeah, and it's interesting to know, we made a test. We have a Ryzen system in our office where until now there was no like QuickSync performance, but now with the latest EDIUS version, we could really see that playing back a 8K 50p file in H.265 had the same performance as HQX file. So the Grass Valley own codec, right, which is iframe based, so very easy to play. Yeah. So it simply played that video like butter. Right. So
yeah. So right now the optimization is not so well at this moment. But even this timing, the GPU decoder provide a better performance. Yeah.
Well, it's not a better performance. It's if you look at it before, without that acceleration and with this acceleration, it's a different like day and night. Yeah. Before you saw it, said, wow, 8K H.265 material, very hard to decode. Was not possible to play it. And now it's just easy.
Yeah. So boost up the performance, yeah, but also the decoding the using the GPU may reduce the CPU load because you can use the GPU for the decoding, so that means the CPU power can you can use a CPU power for other area.
Yeah. So, for example, for effects or things which are not using the GPU, the CPU can work on that, and the decoding process will be done by the GPU.
Yes, correct. Okay. Yeah.
So, in overall, it gives you a better performance on those systems. We did even a comparison with QuickSync against Nvidia decoding. In general, we can see that, of course, the Nvidia cards, they can have even more power than QuickSync. Easy to understand because they can be very expensive. But even like a mid-size Nvidia card brings a very good performance. So what we have seen, maybe this is just an impression, but I also had the impression that the picture itself, the preview on the PC monitor, was very, very fluid. So it was like, before you sometimes could see that frames were missing, even though that EDIUS says in the buffer is full, so there are no frames lost. Is there also a difference?
Yeah, that is what I said. The using the GPU decoder, the more CPU power can use for the another process. So that might bring the more fluent preview quality or the the better performance on the encoder part or those kind of things.
Yeah. I mean, historically, Grass Valley had those I/O cards. There are still I/O cards available. Now other companies produce I/O hardware, so that it's possible to have on a professional monitor to see the video in full quality and the correct frame rate and the correct frame or picture, like HDR or and so in the right colors as well. This priority on the PCI bus, because these cards are always on the PCI bus, that is still the same. So you still can have an I/O hardware.
Yeah. Correctly. Okay. Yeah, but in the use case of the customer, yeah. the use case changed from before. That means the I/O hardware is not the top priority for most customers, because the customer are using the file based workflow. Mm. So the previewing the very important, but the recording or the exporting to the recorder is not so not so usual. So I think the preview performance is more important for the user experience.
Right, and there are new possibilities as well for the preview, like NDI is also supported in the workgroup version.
Yes, so NDI, NDI, so IP transfer is very very popular in customer workflow. So we are looking for the best way how we can implement those things in EDIUS.
Yeah. And what's also new in EDIUS 11.10 is that some filters got also GPU support. Yes. How is that working?
Yeah, so in the GPU pipeline, the primary color correction filter is also GPU accelerate in that context. And so the changing the HDR and the SDR color spaces using the primary color correction is a very heavy process. Already we implemented it in GPU process, but integrating the filter into the GPU pipeline, the user can receive the more benefit from GPU pipeline.
Yeah, maybe not everybody understands the wording GPU pipeline. So obviously there has been a CPU pipeline before, and now there is a GPU pipeline. Is this like replacing the CPU pipeline? And what is a GPU pipeline anyway?
That is some kind of technical term. But the GPU, in the past, we processed all pixel and all frames in the CPU memory. But in GPU process, those frame buffer should be handled in GPU memory. So we mean that the processing in the GPU memory is the GPU pipeline. Yeah. So, but in some case, some environment cannot use the GPU. So we still provide a CPU pipeline for that purpose. So the GPU pipeline is the in many cases the GPU is already there. So we are now focusing to make more performance in common PC environment.
So that does also mean that people can get an additional GPU, but it's not needed to work with EDIUS. And for those who didn't have any GPU acceleration in EDIUS before, for those, it's obviously a very good idea to invest in an additional graphics card to have this decoding and pipeline functionality.
So most customer already have a GPU in the PC system. So our GPU pipeline give a more performance without any additional investment on your PC.
Sounds very good. So what about the future of the GPU pipeline? Is there more acceleration coming? What are the plans?
Regarding the rendering context, the encoder also the GPU has also the some encoders. So we are now planning to enable those encoder function in the future. Not only the encoder, but also some filters and the transients. Most of our transient and the filter are running in CPU. Yeah. So to enable full feature of GPU pipeline, we need to implement those filter and the transient in GPU too. So we are planning to provide the GPU version of those feature set.
Cool. So that means in the end that EDIUS will get even more powerful, even faster in the future, right?
So our focus is the utilizing the full performance from the customer's PC. Mm-hmm. So right now the GPU is the GPU pipeline is the just started, but we plan to bring more performance from your PC.
Tamaoki-san, thank you very much. Maybe as also something which is interesting, talking about GPU, you probably know that GPUs are also used for AI solutions. So as there are some upcoming AI functions for EDIUS by integrating services, this might also be interesting to have a GPU which is capable of doing some AI support. So with this look into the future and the best regards from Kobe, thank you again. All the best. Bye-bye.